प्रणाम महाराज। सो टुडे वी आर विद अनदर टॉपिक एट आवर संडे क्लास। टुडे इज बर्थ एनिवर्सरी ऑफ स्वामी तुरियानंद, वन ऑफ द डायरेक्ट डिसिपल्स ऑफ श्री रामकृष्ण, एंड ही हैज बीन अ वेरी ग्रेट योगी। सो प्लीज महाराज थ्रो सम लाइट इन हिज लाइफ एंड ऑल्सो शेयर सम स्पिरिचुअल वैल्यूबल स्पिरिचुअल टिप्स फॉर our day-to-day life, which can be practiced by us in the light of some lifestyle teachings of Swami Tuliyananda. Over to you, Maharaj. Thank you.
Okay. Today is the birthday of Swami Tuliyananda Hari Maharaj, one of the disciples of Ramakrishna Dev. Hari Maharaj, known as Tuliyananda, he is your study life. He lost his parents in a very young age, at the age of 3. But in the life, 2-3 incidents that happened to change our life. When you watch, in a young age, he has developed reading shastras, Ved, Upanishad, that tendency was there. So he has a habit of reading mainly shastras, books. So when he met Sri Ramakrishna also came to know that he has this kind of tendency of studying so much, habit of reading Vedanta. One day, Sri Ramakrishna asked Hari Maharaj, Tuliyananda, what is written in your Ved and Vedanta? Then Ramakrishna replied, Brahma Satya Jagad Mitha. This is the essence of the Ved, Vedanta. So, do practice. Just like Sri Ramakrishna's that examples, one person who was living in the city got a letter from the village house. He lost the postcard letter. Anyhow, he found and noted down what is to be brought and throw this postcard to the dustbin. That meaning is, you go through these shastras, Upanishads, but what is there? What is to do? Then after that, shastra has no value because you have to practice it. So, Sri Ramakrishna teaches Hari Maharaj, practice. He is very fond of reading Vedanta. That is a wonderful incident from his life. We can get the lesson that practice. And one day Sri Ramakrishna asked Hari Maharaj to keep this knife in table. Just he kept it in a haphazard way. But Ramakrishna, they correct him, no. You keep in the proper place. Proper place, proper way. That means whenever you want to do the work in meticulously, in a disciplined manner, when a person is a disciplined spiritually practicing, spiritual practice, he should keep all these things in a meticulously in the right place. He is known as a living Vedanta, Kamaji said, because his life is such, it is called like a known as a living Vedanta. one day, there are so many incidents there that every time he remembered the Vedanta truth. He's living means all the time, most of the time he remembers this Vedanta's truth and Vedanta's sayings. See, one incident I am telling, when Swami Turiyananda and Atulananda, when in a Paribrajak, when they are traveling, and in the evening they are finding some place to rest, they could not find, got tired, then took rest in under a tree. Both of them were lying in the floor. Floor means just the ground. Then suddenly Hari Maharaj remember the Swamiji's quotation that don't build your house for happiness. How can house can bind you? That means you cannot, house cannot bind you. You cannot be kept in the house. That means you are that Brahman. So immediately remember this quotation of Swami Vivekananda, and he is very much excited. Please, that is, you are living and staying under the tree. And he also one day when Sri Ramakrishna was suffering from pain, cancer, you know, last time you are suffering very much and all are hurried, what will happen? But Turiyananda, when nobody was there, he was sitting and asked Sri Ramakrishna, the knower of Brahman does not know any pain and pleasure. How will be unhappy? Why they are so much anxiety, so much they are thinking of, so much? Knower of Brahman does not know any pain and pleasures. They cannot suffer. Sri Ramakrishna, smiling, told Sala Dhore Veleche, and he understood the truth. So if you see that Hari Maharaj's life, Turiyananda's life, he is full of Vedantic wisdom in his living style. That is why he says his teachings. Trouble exists as long as you live in the domain of thoughts. There is no peace until we transcended thoughts itself. When one kills the mind, the senses come under control. What does it mean to kill the mind? It is to detach it from the sense object. Enlightened person has their senses under the perfect control. The tortoise can draw in its legs. The seer can draw in his senses. I call him illumined. The Vedantic way he is expressing that peace will not come unless you transcended thoughts. Thoughts is mind attached with the object. Senses. Mind and senses. So kill the mind means detach itself from the object. When you detach yourself from the object, then you are able to kill the time. So enlightened person has their senses under perfect control. The tortoise draw legs and seer can draw in senses. I call him illumined. That is a wonderful teachings, that how to detach senses from the mind. The moment we detach senses from the mind, mind means thought, then your mind is killed. Even a mind that knows the path can be dragged from the path. The senses are so unruly. But one who is the wise controls the senses. The persons, he collects the mind and fixes it on me. I call such a person illumined. That means another way is telling the, if you recall God, if you focus your mind on the God, you can detach yourself from the senses. The senses are so unruly because most of the time we are reacting, our actions, everything determined by the emotion. And if emotion is controlled, then our action, our path will be in the right direction. So control your emotions, senses. 10% can go in the right way. And that is possible only by remembering God. Remembering God, believing God, and have a repose faith on it. That is true. So that which is good and pure in you is God. That which is evil in you is your ego. The more you think of him, the more he will increase and he will decrease. Some people are secretive. They raise a wall around themselves. That is bad. Without being sincere, open-hearted, nobody can find God. The peaceful life is a simple life. Be pure and good. That which is evil, it is your ego. That is good, it is God. So by discriminating ego, how will that understand the ego? That which is evil, that is ego, that is not God. So this is the way Turiyananda has given so many teachings in a life. And there is a beautiful book, they are Spiritual Treasures, written by Turiyananda. Beautiful teachings are there. So he never, and full of faith on God, when they are assembled, Turiyananda always used to be in the meditative mood most of the time. So these are the few teachings, whatever I recollect. I can tell you, but you go through the Spiritual Treasures, the book available. You can go through this book. I also used to recommend these books, that sometimes go through this book and the teachings, Vedantic, how to detach the mind. Detachment of the mind is possible when sense objects are negligible to you. That means sense objects are very less important for you. If you develop some power by practicing, that sense object has no value with us. Sense object is value is zero. Value is only God. So try to think and eliminate the sense object is detach yourself and attraction from the sense object, you have to withdraw. ठीक है सब सब अच्छा रहो
यस महाराज थैंक यू
रेड्डी मुक्ता
यस महाराज महाराज वन इंसिडेंट हैपेंड इन लाइफ ऑफ स्वामी जी दैट वंस ही वाज टू बी ऑपरेटेड एंड ही फॉरबिड द डॉक्टर टू अप्लाई एनेस्थीसिया ऑन हिज बॉडी एंड ही विथड्रॉ हिज माइंड फ्रॉम दैट पर्टिकुलर पार्ट ऑफ द बॉडी So
now that incident was, is there.
Yeah, it is the culmination
of no need of anesthesia. You tell, I will withdraw my mind. Not only there, another incident is there when he was very seriously ill. That time, doctor suggesting you eat this one, you eat this one. This is the medicine. Then he says. The real doctor is the God. You are giving the medicine, but real doctor is the God. He is giving through you. So Ganges water is a part of the God. So if I take the Ganges water, my disease will be dissolved, but I will be cured. So he used to take Ganges water in one incident is there without taking medicine or doctor advice. He is to take Ganges water and ultimately he is cured. There are so many incidents there. ठीक है ओके अच्छा है मुक्ता रेड्डी चलो जय ठाकुर मेरा आशीर्वाद लो आनंद में रहो